Welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia. Myself, Deepa Agrawal from ITCS department. In this video, I'm going to explain you green computing topic, that is power usage. This is for FY BSc IT semester 2 students. First, we will see what are the power problems. Power is a huge issue for businesses. To save money and to help the environment in the process that reduces use of electricity. It shows electricity how much we are using and where it can be trimmed. The issue of power consumption and provide some recommendations to reduce it across our IT department's infrastructure from servers to workstations. But even beyond saving the planet and saving money, we need to save power because at some point we may not have enough power to run our equipment. Monitoring power usage. The server room isn't the only place where power gets used. The whole organization uses power all the time. The place to start is with an overall evaluation of the power we use. If an IT professional, then only interested in the computers and network infrastructure. For instance, although reducing server power draws and minimizing PC power usage seems obvious, it might decide to implement a plan where lighting automatically turns off. As small as directing laptop and cellular phone users to disconnect their charges from the wall when they are not in use. Although there is no device plugged into the charger still sips at the electric current. Servers. To monitor power consumption, it must use power monitoring software. Several vendors offer tools that help monitor data center power. As an example, IBM's Power Executive provides the tools needed to watch and manage power consumption accurately. It can measure real-time power consumption and warmth emission by individual server, server group or location. It allows for the optimization of energy use and therefore the lowering the power consumption when low utilization can provide cost savings. These power monitoring and management capabilities are a crucial tool in achieving energy efficiency within the data center. Now we'll see what are the low cost options. There also are some very low cost solutions for checking power on your workstations and standalone devices. First is kilowatt. The kilowatt device may be a product that plug into the wall, then plug to computer or monitor into the device. The result shows ways much power your device is using. Calculator. Tech Republic offers a free worksheet to assist identify various costs for monitor power. It allows us to try to the following. First, determine what proportion of electricity to power our existing monitors. The result shows ways much power our device is using. Compare new LCD and CRT monitors to work out which option is a smaller amount expensive. Now we see how we can reduce the power use. If we get an idea of how much power is consumed, it's time to take steps. There are a number of ways to cut our electric bill. First is data deduplication. Data deduplication is a tool for reducing storage and bandwidth consumed from disk-based backup. By eliminating the necessity to constantly copy an equivalent file over and once again, backup storage consumption is reduced 10 to 50 times. Because less data is shipped across the network, overall bandwidth consumption is reduced by almost 500 times. Second is virtualization. The biggest power draw to our IT infrastructure is from servers. In and of themselves, they will garbage down 50% of the facility coming into our data center. If virtualized the servers, however, advanced clustering technologies allow them to act as traffic cops and move applications between servers and storage devices with precision. This causes a discount within the need for hardware space and energy usage. Third is storage. Storage is another huge area in power consumption. To measure redundancy protecting our data, it's simply wasteful and insufficient to have hundreds of drives resolved away when a number of will do the trick. If an organization uses a lot of direct attached storage, a huge power savings if we switch over to a storage area network that is also known as SAN. By removing file servers, it enables an instant reduction in power usage. A SAN also allows growth in a logical, efficient manner. With direct attached storage to add file servers to the network, the disks are added, which is considerably less expensive. Fourth is management. In many organizations, computers are used for just 4 hours each day. The extra 20 hours, those idle machines are still using energy while offline. The evaluation says that 65% of the energy used by computers and monitors is wasted because workers don't turn off computers when they leave for the day. In addition, half of computers and monitors do not have a power management scheme applied, so more money is wasted when they fail to automatically switch off. A number of utilities are available that empower system administrations to easily manage power setting. Fifth is bigger drivers. Different technological blessings that can help to conserve power is to ditch all older, smaller hard drives and install a new bigger one. Serial SATA drives or storage devices use about 50% less power per terabyte than fiber channel drives. They are also higher in storage device density, which also helps reduce power consumption. For details, if HDD replaces 11 legacy drives with a modern high capacity drive, then get a 16% increase in capacity and use 81% less power. This saves 93% more floor space than with the other system. Next is low power computers. Computer manufacturers are starting to offer low power models that consume less power than other computers. Of course, the workstations need or may not fall in line with the spaces for these machines, but as more and more companies want to save money on power costs, look for more machines to be explained. Servers. Reduce the amount of energy of servers used by deploying blade servers and by virtualizing these servers. Blades are entire computers contained on a card and that can be inserted into a huge device. As such, rather than one server taking a whole rack, 20 blades can be installed into one unit. Blade servers consume about 10% less energy than equivalent rack mount servers, because multiple servers share common power supplies, cooling fans, and other components. Polling. Periodic polling is that the computer automatically checking to see if a given action has been taken draws power from idling computers, because it automatically wakes the computer up to check for a given event. Every time an application calls for something, the CPU wakes from an idle state and consumes power. Not to be able to eliminate all polling tasks, but can manage them. Use large buffers. If any organization is one where media is played from a CD, DVD or hard drive, make sure that applications buffer are set large enough to store as much as all of the media in memory as possible. Doing this reduces the hard drive, DVD or CD drive from spinning as much and thus saves power. Green drives. Green hard drives are drives that lessen the amount of power they use through a collection of mechanisms, including unloading the heads during inactive time to reduce trim drag. Further, the drives calculate the minimum seek speed to use just the amount of power required. MAID. It stands for Massive Array of Idle Disk. It is a system that employs hundreds or thousands of hard drives for nearline data storage. The power used to run them, as well as minimizing the generation of heat, which in turn lesser costing cooling costs. MAID comes with some settlement, however, such as increased latency, lower throughput, and much lower redundancy. Although a MAID solution can be slow, data access can take a few milliseconds up to 10 seconds. It is much faster than tape drive, which can take 60 seconds or longer to access the data. Monitors. Monitor is use 100 watt of power while they are on. In sleep mode, they use 5 watt or less. Adjusting monitors to automatically enter sleep mode after a period of no use device is a quick and easy way to reduce cost of power. LCD plays are not required to be less power hungry than CRTs. It depends on the model. It is the best way to evaluate monitor power. The best way to save energy is to switch off the monitor. Next is software. Although it is possible to manage many power settings using group policy in Windows or a similar tool in Linux and Mac environments, some companies are making the process even easier and marketing power saving software. As repeatedly stated, power consumption is a major issue. It affects the environment. It affects our bottom line by using the mechanism that should be able to see some appreciable cuts in our power usage. So this is all about in this video about power usage. Thank you.